artists like Anita Baker and Toni Braxton are artists who liberated me to feel like I could be an artist, because I grew up in a time where I feel like sopranos were reigning supreme and everybody was like all about the Mariah Careys of the world and like the upper register vocalists.
I have to shout out to, I know Andy mentioned it, but like Anita Baker and Toni Braxton, like you're getting shout outs for your music. How does that feel? Like when you read that on the interwebs or whatever, are you like, what is happening?
Yes, Jared, that's exactly what it's like. It is like, what, like, it's like a WTF moment. I remember when Auntie Anita Baker DM'd me the first time, I didn't believe it. And I was like sitting on the bed in our room and Chris was in the basement. I ran downstairs and I was like, look at this. And he was like, wow. And I broke down. I was like ugly crying, like, like shaking, crying that Anita Baker, even number one, knows who the F I am. Mm-hmm. And number two, like, acknowledges my music, and three, likes my music. Like, what planet, like, what world are, like, do we live, like, this, that's insane to me. And when it is an artist that I have looked up to my entire life, artists like Anita Baker and Toni Braxton are artists who liberated me to feel like I could be an artist, because I grew up in a time where I feel like sopranos were reigning supreme and everybody was like all about the Mariah Careys of the world and like the upper register vocalists. Yeah. And it was people like Brandy and Toni Braxton and, you know, just the OGs of the world, like the Anita Bakers of the world, who made me feel comfortable with my lower register. And Toni is like, when I was growing up, I was in college, I was in the Howard Gospel Choir, and my nickname in the choir was Toni. They would say, Toni is your sister in song, honey. My nickname was Toni. So I look up to Toni like more than anything. So to know that she, one, knows who I am, two, likes my music, and three, one, is listening to it, it's like,
yeah,
my brain is shuts off.
Listen, I get it. I'll be freaking out. Like the Heat, Toni's album, like that is a record.
Oh my God. I used to dance in my room until I was sweating to the Heat. Like, that was my album. Yes.
I was messed up about a man and I was about 6 years old.
A man about it, honey. No, she laid it down for us on the Heat.
She did. And I think it's nice too, because I do think you do hear those influences in the record, in the album rather. But I want to talk too about Benefits Part 2. And I feel like the part two is like an R&B rite of passage too, right? There's like the song, like Confessions Part 2, let's say, like, that is R&B for sure. Like a different, it's not just, it's a kind of bigger than a remix, you know what I mean? It could be a different arrangement, adding someone. How was it working with Q Parker on this and getting able to do Benefits Part 2?
Amazing. Q, so I had met Q a few years ago when he was visiting through a mutual friend. And I told him then that I was working on an album and I would love his feedback. And he's in Atlanta. I'm from the Atlanta area. So he was like, whenever you're in Atlanta, you know, hit me up, we can do something together. And so then when Deep Space came out and then we released Benefits, he called me and was like, yo, I knew you were doing music, but I didn't know it was going to be like this. And I was like, oh my God. And he was like, let's get on something together. And I was like, well, why don't we do Benefits? That's, you know, that makes sense. And he went and he was in the studio when he called me. We got off the phone. I think he wrote his verse like right then. I had my team like send over the track and send over the song, and he wrote his part, he laid it down, and we had it back in like a few days. Wow. And yeah, and it was, and then I had already shot the Benefits video, and he actually is good friends with the guy or the team that shot the Benefits video. Film You Family is the name. And they were able to So we shot Benefits in my mom's house in the basement. And so we ended up shooting part two in my mom's house in the basement. So Q went over there and the videographers went and we were able to line it up to look like we were next to each other. When in actuality, I'd shot my part like months before, and Benefits part two was born.